Hi everybody, Al here. Today I wanted to tell you a little bit about our EGW Universal Radius mounts for red dots. We make them in 670 radius and 468. It's a nice little guy here. We have a bunch of different holes drilled in it to match up with different hole spacings on your receivers. And then you can put a red dot on it. We have four different footprints. One for the Vortex Viper Venom Doctor footprint. We have another one for the Delta Point Pro footprint, which also fits the shields. We have another one for the RMR footprint, which also fits the C-Series Hollow Suns. And we have another one for the Vortex Razor and Seymour footprint. And if we didn't call out your red dots here, we'll add a list of red dots that can scroll up or pause on the screen here. And you can take a look and see if one of those red dots are interesting for you and your build. So it's pretty simple and cool. It's nice and easy. What we normally do is if you have your gun, you'll want to measure the hole spacings that you have on top here and see if it matches up to what we list out on our website under specifications on the mounts page. So I like to use a set of precision calipers, but not everybody can go downstairs and steal them from a machinist. So if you don't have calipers or a tape measure or ruler, we have a really cool gauge here that you can print out on our website under the blog section. And it's a radius gauge, so it can tell you the radius of your receiver if the mount will fit, along with a whole bunch of common hole spacing measurements. So you can check that out and you can hold it up to your receiver and see there's a start here. And if I start here, I can see that these two holes are 860 thousandths apart. So I know that our universal mount will fit it. And then if I'm not sure of the radius and I can't measure that at home, we cut it out and in George's mouth here, we have different radiuses and I can start here and say that's too small. This one's too small but close, and then 670 seems to fit. So I think that our 670 universal mount will fit on there. And sure enough, would you look at that?
Oh my gosh, just look at it!
It does. So these are really cool. They're made from 6061 aluminum. They're Type 3 hard coat anodized, so they're very rugged and durable, and they'll hold up really well for you. We have a nice shoulder cut for the heads here, so it's a taper head screw, so you don't really have to worry about recoil because the shoulder of the head is designed to hold up against it. There's no square corners, so our engineers took lots of time thinking about that and making a nice sturdy mount for you and your red dots. So if you want to follow along in the second part of the video, I'll be installing this on one of these guns for you, and we can go from there. So our EGW Universal Red Dot mounts, they fit a whole bunch of different guns, rifles, shotguns, and so much more. So I have a shotgun here that it'll fit. I have a nice little shockwave here. We have one on with a nice red dot on it. This is the Vortex Defender CCW. I mean, heck, anything around the house, we have our tactical broom here, so we're not missing any dust bunnies when we're sweeping up. We even put one on scope knife, and just even for festivities, I mean, come on people, you can even put them on a pumpkin. So get your universal mounts, get creative with it, put a red dot on anything. So you have your gun set up here. This one, we've already removed the plug screws that came in it from the factory, and we've already checked to make sure that the gun is clear and unloaded. So what I like to do is I like to take a rag and clean the top of the receiver here just in case there's any oil or grease. And I took a Q-tip with some alcohol and I ran it through the threaded holes here. That way they're all cleaned out and there's no oil in there, so the Loctite will be able to engage and dry as it should. So I'm going to start off with the universal mount. You want to make sure that you have it on properly. So usually there's a part number on it engraved on the top, and that part number is going to be on the front side of it. So whatever side that part number favors is the front of it, and then the other side is the rear. So make sure that you have this facing the proper direction. Otherwise, you're going to put on backwards and your red dot will be backwards and it'll look a little bit silly, but you could still use it that way technically, I guess. So I'll pop that on here. Now you're going to get all these fun bags of screws. When you open up the mount here, we have the blue ones are 648 wide head screws. So if you have a 648 thread, these will work in there. They're wide head because we have the holes drilled out for number 8 screws in here. So the wide head of the number 6 screws gets a lot of engagement on there and they hold up great. We have a set of screws in a clear bag. These are button head screws for an optic. I have another one which is flathead screws for the optic. You may not get the button head or flathead screws. It may vary depending on what optic choice you choose. So these screws will vary depending on the part number that you get. We have screws in a red bag. The screws in the red bag are number 840 screws, 313 overall length, so they're the shorter of the two number 8 screws. And then we have screws in a yellow bag, and these are also number 840 screws, and these are 335 overall length, so these are a little bit longer than the other ones. So some guns, such as the Versa Max, they need a little bit more hangout, a little bit more thread engagement, and you would use these. If you would use these and your bolt holds up somewhere, or you're not able to thread them in all the way, back that one or two screw out and put in the red screw and see if that'll be able to get you. If both of the screws don't work for you, give us a call, 215-538-1012, and get on the phone with our tech support, and we have some varying length screws here in the shop, and we can work with you on getting the correct thread screw. So next, I'm going to take a little dab of blue Loctite, and you know what they say, a little dab of blue, yeah? So a little dab of blue, and pop it on each of these screws here, and pop them in the corresponding holes. And now it's a T10 drive for the screws, and I have my Wheeler fat wrench set to 20 inch pounds. So let's torque those down to 20 inch pounds with a little dab of blue Loctite. I'm gonna snug up one side, snug up the other side, and then I'll go back and torque them through. And now it's time to mount our red dot on top of the universal mount. I'm gonna take my red dot now, which happens to be a Vortex Venom, pop it into place. Sometimes the red dot will go on a little bit hard. The hard coat buildup on the pins, sometimes it's a little bit thicker than other times, so you may have to press down on the red dot a little bit to get it to go onto the plate. You never wanna force it or hit it with a hammer or anything like that, so if it doesn't seem right, maybe you have the wrong footprint or the wrong components here, so give us a call if you run into that issue before you break something. And we're not using blue Loctite on these screws. You can if you want to, but these usually get removed more often than not, and they're hex head drive, so a lot of people run into stripping them out, so we recommend just screwing them down. I screw mine down to between 12 and 15 inch pounds. You can look in your handbook for your red dot and see what the manufacturer of the red dot recommends for their components here. Some might recommend 8, I'm not sure, so look in the handbook and see what they recommend torquing the screws down for the dot. But generally 12 to 15 pounds is where it's going to be, and that's in inch pounds, not foot pounds. So we're going to adjust our wrench down here. Got it set for 12. And once again, I'm gonna get one screw down, snug it, then do the other one, and do final torque values. And this is a 5/64 inch drive, just in case I missed that. So 5/64 inch Allen key drive to tighten down the screws there. And that's as simple as it is to get one of our EGW universal red dot mounts on top of one of your firearms. Like we said, it fits shotguns, rifles, handguns, broomsticks, anything you really want it to. And we have lots of tools and guides on hole spacings and radiuses, all available on our website. And if you can't find it or you're not sure, feel free to give us a call and one of our tech support agents will be really happy to help you out and talk to you and get you set up with the right components. Thanks again for watching our videos. Please leave a comment below, like, subscribe, and follow for more. Stay blessed.